Another rumble.
Like it's a trigger word for conservative.
something is triggered in somebody's mind, and then all of a sudden they're fighting, like they're from a game or something like that.
So what I want people to understand is,
so that's the long, the short story of Peter Rail. You know, talk about people who haven't had formal education, but secretly admire, you know, street dudes that you know that's got street cred.
Speaking right now.
Of which I hope to speak, the Frederick Douglass and Marcus Garvey. Leadership Academy for African Children.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Was opened on September the
24th,
1880,
by a
contemporary of the great
Washington.
That great ancestor's name was James Salvador Russell. Father Russell,
because
opened this college with less than a dozen students. And by the time it reached its zenith, owned more than 1,000 acres of land and housed more than 1,000 African children. But unfortunately,
I'm a stand-up person. I'm all for what the truth is. And I mean, this guy, I have no problem with him sitting here checking people because they're out of line. And the fact that they're going after his wife and his livelihood, his criminal record and all that is absolutely disgusting. And I just want to say, Taz, you go ahead and tell me your business. That's all.
But other than that, all that Umar Johnson does is
okay, let's Throw up the Christmas mentality where we a little more Afrocentric, a little him to use social media platforms, but he didn't get the actual green light from the judge, and they got him pulled this shit. And got they tried to lock him back up. But I know he can't be on social media no more.
Nash ain't been back on here since.
Umar!
Charges, especially on military bases, like playing until they threaten his ex-wife and baby mama when he got there gonna rifle and stuff.
Yeah. You watch all them videos I did on him before that. I ain't never mentioned none of that shit because none of that shit was in the media. They never put that shit out, though. So I didn't even know that. Everything I did about him, you know, nothing includes none about his wife, his kids, and none of it. It's all about what he was doing on social media. It's all a social media footprint. So, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Oh, wow.
I know Grandmaster J was frozen like that, you know, and they're
like Umar, bro, I'm telling you, bro, like I said, I only say he first because we got this fight the power mentality right now, and he used that shit to hurt me before. Yeah, one hell of a summer, bro, I'm telling you.
Yes, he had. And he got a larger reach now, Jermaine, because he gets way more money than Jermaine gets, at, like, much faster. One point in time, too, because he got a lot of people talking. He's way more visible than Jermaine is. Shit, then he got assault rifles in his hand talking about fighting back against a goddamn old white police station. I said, oh, shit, alright.
Well, speaking of Jermaine, one thing I brought up in the chat. What happened to his other girl that sent him out of 60 G's?
Yeah. She in the background. I told you she put up those, wrote up the books. The Black Parrot Happy. I think she was ghosting about that.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, woo! This is getting good on both of these channels, boy. Woo! Man, this is some juicy stuff. Wow. I'm even shocked at what I heard just now. I'm floored. Wow. Oh boy. Oh my. The rumble will continue. But I'm going to, I didn't want to bore you with all this, but I just want to let you know the rumbles are on. We'll be continuing on with the saga of Lenon versus Umar and the others on YouTube. Stay tuned. And if you're out there, go click on the chat, because it's getting juicy. And the rumble continues and the drama plays out. Alright then, till next time, you guys take care.